Dr. Donna.
Welcome back to my channel.
Oh my gosh. Tired today, I don't know, but I've been tired today.
Today though, I'm going to start off my back to school series.
Yay!
Did I start back?
Just a minute to collect words.
I start school August 7th, so I'm starting my back to school series today. Thank you. Not all my videos that I'll post now and then are going to be back to school related, but most of them will be.
I figured I'd start off the list of my pros and cons of ECHS and why I chose it.
Okay.
Now, I have been listening here once, and it sucked. We're going to do it another time. So, we're going to test again. Maybe everything will work better. Like, my voice kept going out and in, out and in, out and in. So it was really weird. So, try this now. Now that I have better lighting and everything else. It's like 11 o'clock
at night, so I'm kind of tired. But I'm trying to get filming done. So. First, what is ECHS? ECHS is early college high school.
Early college high school is where you take college classes and high school classes together, and basically the goal is for you to graduate with some form of college credits and your high school diploma in just 4 years.
Let's do this.
So we're going to start off with the cons, the not so good things. There is no sports teams or band. It just doesn't exist.
It's
not an option. You cannot do that. No. No. You'll have to play on like a rec team or something.
If you want to, or if you even have time.
But I don't think time's
in the schedule. Because, I mean, everyone there is supposed to be school-focused, not sports-focused. So,
not really. How that's going. Not all my friends will be there.
Exactly.
Not all your friends are going to either make it
or want it. Most of my friends didn't want it.
They're like, I don't want to take college and high school. I want the high school experience. That's their choice. And then friends that did try it didn't make it. Because there's actually a lot of requirements. They're looking at grades. Like how many times you've been written up, you know, your behavior. And you have teacher recommendations.
You go to an interview and you write an essay.
So it's like, it's a lot to take in for getting into it. So it's like, it took some work.
So I'm very, very, very proud of myself for doing that. And then the waiting game is just, oh my god. No.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Oh, no. The waiting game, after
you've done did everything, and it's just their choice. No. No one's ever.
But no one's ever gonna like it.
No one's ever going to approve it. It's just something
you do.
Longer school days. A typical school day is 8 to 3. Yeah, 7 hours. But no. School days without clubs after school or anything else
is 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m.
And then there's a lot of homework. So yeah, longer school days.
So if you can barely stay in school for the normal 7 hours, early college than you think.
Harder classes. Yes. All high school classes are. You're made to take
high school classes on a.
Okay.
High school classes must be taken on honors level.
And then you have
your college classes, which are going to be difficult for anybody, but especially a high schooler who's learning high school material. Like, I was just learning high school material this morning, and now I'm doing college. Huh? That's a little confusing to think about, so I just imagine going through it.
More homework. Yes.
There's about 2 to 2.5 hours of homework each and every night, and homework does not count as studying.
People, whenever I hear someone say, "I did my homework last night and it took me an hour, so I studied for an hour." No, no, you didn't. That's not how that works.
It's
homework and studying are two different things. Not a lot of free time. There's just not. I mean, imagine this. A 9.5 hour school day.
Wait, 9 hours? No, 8.5 hour school day.
2.5 hours of homework. And then an hour in studying.
That's almost half your day gone. And then you have to get to bed and do it all the next morning.
No. And this one goes on with the other one. No time with friends. There's literally going to be no time with friends.
I mean, unless you and your friends have studied, and most of the time your best friends from middle school that's not there are not going to want to study with you for like an hour each night on college and high school stuff when they're not taking the classes, so it won't do them any good.
So, yeah.
No time with friends. Friends are off the picture. Unless you have the study group, obviously.
Alright. And that was my bad things that I had to consider whenever you look
in early college. Those are some things you just gotta know. Alright. Pros, higher education. Yes, you will have higher education.
I mean, it's a higher education opportunity.
So, higher education.
I don't even think I need to go into that one.
2 years of free college. Yes.
Parents will probably really enjoy this. But yes, it's free college. Like, you don't have to pay for
college. So, yeah. And it can lead to better scholarships
if you do really good there. They're like, oh, they already know college. Then they should come here and do this.
And do loan scholarships. So,
starting college sooner. I mean, you're gonna go ahead and get college, well, 2 years of it, out of the way while you're in high school. It's 2 years of college, and that's 2 years closer to your career. Graduating with higher level of education.
Yes. I mean, think about walking across that and them going, they not only have their high school diploma, but they have their associate's degree in science.
Like, yeah, that's going to be people's faces. And you're going to feel even more proud. Closer to my career, faster. Your career comes faster. The more college you already go ahead and do, the closer you are to that career. And the closer time you're saving.
And yes, because some people
think about this. And the more money you're making. Entering college at a higher rank.
Yes, that means you will be the same age as college freshmen, but going into junior classes.
Like, what? They'd be like, dang, no. They got their game on. Like, they are on top of it. They got this. That's me, their thoughts.
And last but not least is having friends that understand your problems.
Yes, you're going to lose friends, obviously. Because you're not going to be able to talk much. Friends that don't go to your school,
you're going to lose them. But, I mean, that's the way of life.
You're going to lose friends and you're going to gain friends.
Kind of a cycle. But
you will have friends
that are there
that know the struggle. Like, oh my gosh, school has gotten me stressed because of college and high school classes. Like, what?
Yeah. Yeah. You've got friends that know that.
Alright, now I'm going to talk about why I chose it.
I had an opportunity to go in for 4 years of JROTC, promised to me. Or I had early college.
Those are both really good opportunities. It was which one was going to help me out.
Becker more. I thought I was originally going to go into the Air Force as a medic. And then come out and be a heart surgeon.
I like the idea of just
going through college first. Now I am. But, like,
it was a good opportunity because I thought that was my career plan. But I knew I was going to need the college no matter what happened. I was going to need the college.
Like, no matter what way I needed to take to my career, I was going to have a college.
So, I came to the decision to early college.
And I would have higher education.
So, like, more and better education.
I would reach my career goals sooner. So yeah, me being a cardiovascular surgeon
is gonna happen in
11 years from graduating than 13. Doesn't sound like a lot, but I'm sure I'll thank myself for that later.
And I won't be single.
Not as like a nerd.
I'm hoping that there won't be kids that don't care about their schoolwork and kids that do care about their schoolwork.
There might be a few, but really like,
most people are supposed to be there because they care about their school and they care
about the grades and they care about their education.
So I'm not going to be the only one that cares. Okay, you guys.
I hope you guys enjoyed
the video of me talking about the pros and cons and things like that. Just know that you need to consider all these and more whenever you make the decision if you're going to go to early college or not.
Make the decision that's
best for you. What's going to fit your life and fit your goals best. So therefore, take your goals,
go with them, and follow the right path.
Bye, guys.